Hey, what's up guys? Nunu here. I've recently posted this image on Instagram and I've got a lot of requests to make a video about it. So today I'll show you how you can quickly make an exterior image with D5 Render. So let's get started. So let me start by saying that this will not be a step-by-step tutorial, but it will be a scene breakdown. I'm just going to show you the basic things to achieve this type of render, what I did or where I find some type of assets to build this scene. And I use the D5 Render 2.0. And if you want to know more about this version, I'll give a link in the top right corner for my video about the top features about D5 Render 2.0. So let's start. Here I have my scene. And as you can see, I have here a house. Let me just change this to lit mode. Okay, and so I have here this house. I want to first speak about the assets. So these assets that you see here, it's a very basic scene, by the way. If you notice, I just have two hills, one and another, then it's duplicated. I have the house itself, one tree from D5, another set of trees from D5 library, the same hills here duplicated, and then this is just a background image. So, and then we have this eagle flying around here. So it's a very, very basic scene. And as for the 3D model, I went to a site called 3D Sky. They have a lot of good, high quality models that you can get. And I also made a video about the top websites to get 3D models. I'll leave a link as well in the top right corner and also in the description so you can watch it. And so this house, it's like this. It came with these materials. I changed a little bit in D5 to fit the style that I was going for. So instead of this black, I used white. They're quite affordable here. It's just $7 for the assets, the pro assets. But you can search for free as well. You can go to the 3D warehouse from SketchUp and here just type glass house and you'll find a lot of models that you can download to make a similar scene like this one. So even this one. So here you have a lot of things. And as for the background, you can go to a site called Ambient CG. All of these textures here on this website and all of the assets you can use for free. And you can go to the categories and you'll have here one that is called backdrop. So in this backdrop, you can find some background for trees. Like this one, or let's see. This one has some issues, I think, but let's see. For example, this one could work better. It's always best to have some backgrounds like this, so you don't have like this infinite horizon line. This immediately tells that it's a 3D render. And for the mountain, you can go to even to 3D warehouse again, and you can find these background mountains. So you can find some here. Let's put it and. And so here you can see even some mountains, 3D, more background mountains. So you can find here this type of assets as well that you can use. And so this is for the house, for the background. And now for this here, I went to Quixel and they have the mega scans. And these mega scans are very high quality 3D scan assets. So let me go ahead and open Quixel Bridge. This Quixel Bridge, it's an application that you can use from Quixel to download all your assets from the Megascans library and then even connect them directly to 3ds Max, for example, or Unreal Engine. They don't have for D5 Render, but you can simply download them and then apply the textures. And so I use from these Nordic coastal cliffs. So if you go here, you can see even some references. So let's go to the assets and you can see here the assets. So here, this green ones is the ones that I already downloaded. And I think I downloaded, let me just show you which ones I did download. So actually it wasn't from the Nordic coastal, it was actually from the Icelandic. So if you go here to this environment and natural, they have a lot of categories and they have this Iceland. And on this Iceland, you'll find here as well You can see that it's similar to that Nordic Coastal. And I think I used this one. And you can go here to all sizes and make, for example, size bigger than 8 meters. And you'll find everything that is bigger than that. So I think I use this one. So this one is actually free. You can download it for free. And this one here as well. I use this one. And so you can go here and start downloading and try to mix and match. And when you are doing this, you just need to be careful not to, for example, if I go here, imagine that I place this like this, right? So if I go now to my view, well, you can see that we have a big issue because we are seeing here this open model, right? So it's always best to try to hide it the best. So maybe put it a little bit inside the other model, okay? So you don't have any parts that are open on your 3D model. And so, for example, here as well, this way it will not look so nice. What you could do is just go here and just turn it. Oops. Just push it a little bit, and then we can even rotate like this. But doesn't fit so well, so maybe we could even scale it a little bit and just push it a little bit more to the front. Okay, now we can see that it's starting to, on these areas, to blend. See, it blends much better. Oh, by the way, I just want to remind you that I have my D5 render course. It's a step-by-step tutorials with the exterior, interior, and animation modules. I'll leave a link in the top right corner and also in the description below this video. So now you can see, and this part here, I try to use this one. It's actually from the Nordic Coastal. Let me just go here so you can see. And this asset, this one, it's actually with a LOD0. And that, what does this mean, LOD0? If you go here and you download something, you click here and you go to the settings here on this gear. Export settings, sorry, not export, go to download settings. And when you click the models, you'll see that it says LOD 0, LOD 1, LOD 3, LOD 4, 5, and also the high poly source. So the high poly source is the model with the highest resolution, and the LODs, it's versions that has less polygons, and so they are, and so they'll be faster on your 3D application. And what I recommend to do is go here and let's say it's this one. Let's take this one as an example. And so here I have the folder with this asset. You can see that it comes with a high, with a LOD0, LOD1, 3, and 5. So this is the versions that I selected to download. You can select this. And if we go here now to D5, you'll see that it has here, replaced from local folder. Let's click it. And so we can select a different version. Right now, this is a LOD0. Let's select the LOD5 so you can see the difference. And so you see that it has way less polygons. I'm even going to make this display the wireframe. So you can see here the geometry. Actually, we can see clearly now the geometry of this. If I load again the LOD0, see that it has much higher poly count. And let me put again delete mode. Now we can select the high poly, but before we do this, what I recommend you is to work with even the LOD5 version, because it's much smoother to work and you will not have any issues with your frame rate. And just when your scene is final, you can go to all of these assets and then replace to the final version, which is the high poly. So let's do that now. And so now you can see the difference in the quality of the 3D model. Of course, this is only useful if you are more close to the model. If you are very far away, you'll not notice any difference, even between the LOD5 version. So it's up to you to take these decisions. And if I go here to the display and I show you now the wireframe, now you can see that it's a really, really high poly model. So we can keep this one here for now. And let's go here back to this scene too. And so I placed here this tree. I think now it moved a little bit, but I use this tree from this assets. If you go here to the asset from D5, if you go to model, you'll find here some nature. So this nature, you have a lot of trees. And so I selected this one. And I also use the new path tools from D5. So I created here a path. Let me go closer. So I created here a path and I set these parameters here that you see on the right side. I selected two types of trees and I just wanted these trees to be here. So it kind of, since I know that I'm going to cut the image here on the bottom, right? I just wanted to feel like this part here, it's more like a valley. And so with this sun just catching on this area, it creates this very nice effect. And as for the environment itself, I'm using the geo and sky, pretty straightforward. I'm using the clouds as well, the new cloud system. I'm using the fog. If I take away the fog, half of this scene is gone. So the fog here is quite important in this scene. And I'm using the wind as well, even though I was thinking to use this for a video, but then I used just for a still image render. So the wind here doesn't matter so much. And as for the effect, I just adjusted the exposure, the contrast a little bit. So all of these settings, the bloom. So the bloom, it's important if you want to have this highlight here, overexposure here. So just a little bit, just slightly. And also the lens flare. It's important if you want to have, when you are here on this scene, see this lens flare, it's when you have this on the camera. So if you want to have that, you can activate here. And then after this, you can just go to click here on the top image and let's take a render. So in my case, it was a square. So I can select here the 5x5 preset and you can select here the size that you want and you can select the channels as well. And then you can hit render. And after this, this is the image that came with the render. It's far from finished. That's why I always recommend to do some post-production, especially for color correction and some color grading as well. So if you go here, I'm going to activate here the camera raw filter. So this camera raw filter, you'll find here on filter and then camera raw filter. And this camera raw filter, you can still adjust the temperature of your scene. So for this case, more warm temperature, it's nice. You can adjust the exposure if you want brighter or not. You can exposure the highlights, the shadows. So all of this you can control here. And let me just cancel because I already have one filter here. And then I added the color lookup. And this color lookup, it's basically, it's called a LUT file. You can find these LUT files on the internet. You can find for free, you can find paid ones. Basically, they have already some color grading. And I'm using this one, this color lookup. And then you have the exposure here, one adjustment layer for exposure, which basically I'm just creating a little bit more on this glass, a little bit more of this effect. So before and after. And so this way I'm kind of drawing the attention towards this area more. And then I use the hue and saturation to saturate a little bit more the yellow part of this area here. Then these curves, I felt that this area here on the bottom was still too visible. So I adjusted the curves to be a little bit darker, these areas, and created a mask to just mask on this area. Then I added the color balance to slightly adjust a little bit better the colors. Here you can control the midtones, the shadows, and the highlights separately. And then I added a layer with a gradient just on some areas to further enhance this volumetric effect from the sunlight. And then I added a color to this volumetric effect. So I want it to be yellow. So first I added white and then I added a color fill. So here I can control better. For example, if I wanted to go crazy and make it red, I can. So, but to be unrealistic. So then I added some lens effects, some vignetting as well. And The last one, it was the some slight noise to the image, so you can see the before and after. And this is all the steps I took to create this image. This was done pretty fast. My idea with this image was to make like a speed rendering, just placing some ready assets and try to get the best out of this D5 for this exterior scene. And I would like to remind you that if you want to learn more about D5 render, I do have a course for that, and I'll leave a link in the top right corner and also in the description below this video. And I hope you liked this video, and if you did, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.